Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are continuing with our mechanical properties of fluids. In last video, we learned about the Stokes' law and Reynolds' number. And next is surface tension. What is meant by surface tension? It is the property by virtue of which the fluid surface will have a tendency to decrease its surface area or tendency to have a minimum surface area. That is called a surface tension. It is the property of a fluid in which the liquid surface or fluid surface will always try to attain a minimum surface area. This property is called as surface tension. The property of a fluid in which the fluid surface will be exerting a minimum surface area, that is called a surface tension. Okay, how we can find out the surface tension? Surface tension of the fluid. So if this is the fluid surface, then any tangent acting on the force acting per unit length. Through any tangent, if I am considering a force, surface force acting per unit length is called as surface tension. Surface tension S is the surface force acting per unit length. So we can say it is Newton per meter as the unit. Okay, surface force acting per unit. The force should act tangentially to the surface. That is the only condition. That force vector should act tangentially to the surface. Okay, so next is surface energy. So how we can find out the surface energy? Okay, what is this surface energy? How we can find out? Work done will be equal to energy. Work done per unit area, that is called as surface energy. Now we are going to find out the formula for surface energy. So next is surface energy. What is meant by this surface energy? See, I am considering a fluid inside a beaker. Here, I am considering three points. See, one is over here, A, and the other is over here, B, and other is just on the surface, C. Okay, so what, see, to this part A, for this molecule A, it will be having force in all the direction by all other particles near to it. So we can say that the net force acting on the molecule, that is at A, net force will be equal to zero. But what about B? See, number of particles above are less, but more number of particles are below that. So force is at B, the net force is acting downwards, but it will be less downward force. But some molecules are above this, so it will be giving an upward force also, but the downward force is more. Okay, and we are considering a molecule at C. At C, what will happen? See, through the surface, this is acting in opposite direction. Rest all the molecules are acting force in the downward direction. So it is acting, more forces acting downward direction. So all these molecules are pulling it downwards. So it is acquiring, downwards, what will happen? It will be having a tendency to, it will act as a stretched membrane. Okay, the surface will be acting as a stretched membrane. Okay, so that is at C. Okay, that is why it will be having always a minimum surface area. And here the molecule, it is acting as a stretched membrane. So if we need to take one molecule from down to top, what we should do? It has net force is zero, isn't it? So no work is done to do, that. See, if this molecule is under equilibrium position. Now if we are taking it in the upward direction, what will happen? We should do some work against that to carry it to the upward direction, isn't it? That is, its potential energy is more over there. Work done will be converting as energy, isn't it? So it's, while it is, we are taking it to a height h, all the molecules on the surface will be having a potential energy. Okay, because so this will be, so if it is, energy is there, that means it is an unstable condition. So always it will try to get less energy in the less energy. All the molecules wants to be in the stable position or equilibrium position, but this has energy, it needs to vent out its energy, but it is not having any scope for that. So they will try, if they can't release the whole energy, at least if they are getting a minimum energy, it is good, right? So they will be acquiring always a minimum surface area. They will try to acquire a minimum surface area. So that is the molecular, this is called as the molecular theory of the surface tension. Okay, so and if same kind of molecules are coming together, so if we are taking water, and see, while we are dipping hand in water, what will happen? See, it, all the water molecules will be coming in our hand, isn't it? So that means some fluid particles, when one different molecules are there also, if it is different also, they will be mixing nicely. Okay, so there is a force of attraction between different molecules. That is called as adhesive force. There is an adhesive force between the molecules of water and all other objects. But if we are putting one drop of water on an oily surface, what will happen? It won't stick to that oily surface, isn't it? What is the reason? Because there is no force of attraction between different molecules. They will be having force of attraction between same molecules. That is called as cohesive force. Okay, so if the force of attraction between the different molecules, that is our hand and our dress materials with water and all, it will mix very fast, isn't it? It's dress materials, another property also there that we will study afterwards. But if we are taking your hand and dipping it in it, or we are water is pouring on floor, what will happen? It will very easily attach to the floor, isn't it? That means force of attraction between different molecules is more over there. That is adhesive force. That is a force of attraction between only between the same particles, that is oil surface and oil. If we are taking and keeping one drop of water on it, oil surface, what will happen? Oil will be separate and water will be separate, isn't it? That means in the case of oil, it will be sticking to only to the same kind of materials, okay, same kind of molecules. That is why it is called as cohesive force. They will be having a strong cohesive force between them. Okay, so here, understood? So this is the molecular theory behind it. So if we want to calculate the surface energy, what, so minimum surface area it is acquiring, so work done per unit surface area, that is called a surface energy. So minimum surface area, to acquire the minimum surface area, how much work we should do? Work done per minimum, that surface area is called as surface energy. So first we need to find out the work done and the potential energy, how much potential energy will be increased, that also we will find out, and can find out the surface energy. Shall we do the derivation now? Here I am considering a rectangular frame, okay, that is A, B, C, D. Rectangular frame I am considering, E, F. Okay, it is movable, okay, so till CD first I am considering, till CD. And I am keeping one soap frame on this, one soap film I am keeping on this, okay. So suppose if we are, usually we will be doing, right, small children will be doing as taking the soap here and will be increasing the surface area like this, isn't it? Same way here also we are taking a circular this frame and we'll be pushing it towards this direction. Okay, now it became C dash D dash. We applied a force in this direction which gives a displacement of x. Okay, now here surface tensional force is acting, isn't it? Surface tension will be acting in this direction. This direction also surface tension is there. Okay, we need to find out the work done to increase the surface area. Work done to increase the surface area. Increase surface area. How we can find out the work done? Force into displacement. Okay, displacement. What is the force? We know that surface tension S is equal to force acting per unit length. So what will be F? F is equal to S into L. Here, for a soap film while we are considering, it has two sides, isn't it? So we should consider 2S into L, okay, into displacement. So here, not S, we should consider 2S, since the two surfaces we are considering, 2S into L into displacement. How much is the displacement? X. Okay, here I am rewriting it as S into 2L into X. Okay, now I am considering the surface area. The increase in surface area, how much it is? Increase in surface area. Increase in surface area. See, area is, see, X is increase if this side is of length L. So, length into breadth. This is 2, twice it is 2L into X. The other side also we should consider. So 2L into X is the increase in surface area, that is equal to delta A. So here work done to increase the surface area, work done will be equal to S into delta A. Okay, so the surface energy, so this work done will be called as surface energy. This work done is stored as the surface energy. So work done per unit area, surface tension will be called as work done per unit area, or we can write it as surface energy per work done will be, work done will be equal to energy, isn't it? Work energy theorem. Surface area, surface energy divided by area, that is surface tension. Another definition for surface tension is if surface energy will be, surface tension will be equal to the work done to increase the surface area in unity. Isn't it? Work done by to the surface area to unity is called as surface tension. That is, if W, if area equals 1 meter square, then surface tension will be equal to the work done to increase the surface area. That is surface tension, another definition we can write out. So you understood how we are finding out the surface energy. So surface energy equals, surface energy equals surface tension into increase in area. Okay, so understood how we are finding out the surface energy. So next is excess pressure. What is meant by excess pressure? Okay, so I am considering a fluid in a plane. Okay, the surface is plane like this. So on the plane, the surface tensional force acting will be along the tangent, in this direction it will be. Okay, so this will be balancing it with this one. So surface tension force will be equal to zero over there. Okay, so the net force acting will be zero. Okay, now I am considering a fluid in this manner. So here fluid is here. Till here, fluid is there. I am considering this fluid. What will be the surface tension? Surface tensional force will be acting in this direction. Okay, this will be along the tangent. What will, see, the surface tensional force, I am considering the rect components. These are the components. What is happening? This and this will get cancelled. Horizontal components will get cancelled, but the vertical components will add up. Okay, so excess force is acting in this side, that is on the concave side, an excess force is acting that will give us an excess pressure in that concave side. In the same way, next we are considering this fluid in this manner, that is fluid is acting in this way, so the surface tension will be acting like this, okay, through the surface, isn't it? So here the net forces, right, components are like this, and here surface tension will be acting in this manner, and the components will be here, and here this will be the components. So what will happen, these two will get cancelled, horizontal components will get cancelled, but the vertical components will be existing like that, that is towards the concave side an excess force is acting. Okay, surface tension is acting in this side, so always an excess pressure will be there inside the concave surface. Okay, always. So if we are considering a soap bubble, so always water droplet, all those things while we are considering, always it will be spherical in nature. Always it will be spherical in nature. The reason is it is having minimum surface area. So always the liquid will be at try to attain minimum surface area because it wants to decrease its energy at the surface. Okay, to come to the stable position. So to the minimum surface area, water droplets and all the molecules, all the fluids will try to attain a minimum surface area. Minimum surface area is there only for the sphere. That is why it is trying to acquire the minimum surface area like spherical surface. Okay, so while we are considering a sphere, a liquid drop or liquid bubble like this, what will happen, excess pressure will be there inside. Okay, so now we are going to find out the excess pressure of a soap bubble and a soap or water drop. Okay, soap bubble and water drop, what will be the excess pressure? What is the difference between a bubble and a drop? Bubble and a drop. Drop means inside also fluid will be there. Here bubble means inside it will be empty. Excess pressure of a liquid drop. Liquid drop means it is inside, it is filled. So we should we no need to consider the other side. If it is empty, surface tensional force also will be there. Here no surface tensional force inside, only the outside surface tension we should consider. So because of excess pressure, if PI minus PO, the difference in pressure is called excess pressure, that one I am considering it as P. Okay, so if because of that P, if it is increasing its surface area, see this is increasing by an amount delta R, if it is increasing by an amount delta R, so R is the initially it was R, now it became R plus delta R with an increase of delta R. Okay, understood, right? We are going to find out the excess pressure. Work done to increase the surface area, to increase surface area, how we can find out force into displacement. What is the force acting on this surface displacement, force into displacement, don't confuse with SS, surface tension. So I'll write down it as displacement only, force into displacement. So force into displacement is delta R. F is equal to P into A. Okay, so P equals F by A. So F is equal to P into A. So what we can find out, pressure, excess pressure into area into delta R. What is excess pressure? We considered it as P. P into, what is the area of the sphere? 4 pi R square into delta R. This is the work done to increase the surface area. Now, what will be the increase in surface area? Increase in surface area will be equal to 4 pi into R square, increased surface area minus original surface area. 4 pi r plus delta r the whole square minus 4 pi r square. Understood, right? This is first we are considering the increased surface area. Then we are considering this surface area. So while we are subtracting these two, we will be getting the surface area at this portion. Isn't it? So 4 pi r plus delta r the whole square minus 4 pi r square. From that I am taking 4 pi outside. Okay. So here 4 pi r square plus 2 r plus delta r the whole square minus r square. This r square and r square will get cancelled. Here delta r is a very small quantity. So while taking the square, this will be very, very small. So we are neglecting that one. So we finally we will get it as 8 pi r delta r. 4 pi into 2 r delta r, 8 pi r delta r. Now, what will be the increase in potential energy? Potential energy, how we can find out? Here, we see surface energy divided by area equals surface tension. So surface tension into delta A, increase in area is this surface energy. Surface energy is given as increase in potential energy. So I told you, right, to take a molecule from inside the drop to the top, we should do some, it will be getting some potential energy. So what is the increase in potential energy? That will be the surface energy. So surface energy equals surface tension into delta A. Surface tension into delta A is increase in area, that is 8 pi r delta r. We know that work done will be equal to energy. So we can write it as S into 8 pi r delta r, that is equal to P into 4 pi r square delta r. So 4 pi, 8 pi, this is 2, and r, r, delta r, delta r. So what we are getting it as P, P is equal to 2S by r. This is for a excess pressure of a liquid drop. Okay, so clear for you? So if this is for a liquid drop, in the same way you try to do the liquid bubble. If we are taking a soap bubble, how the force excess pressure will be, what change it will happen for a bubble? Bubble means we should consider the two surfaces, inside surface and outside surface. Increase in surface area in both the sides we should consider. So we should just multiply 2 along with this. So here you will be getting 16 pi r delta r. So same way you will get it as the final as answer as 4s by r. Same method we should do. Work done you should find out first, then you should find out the increase in potential energy. Increase in potential energy is the surface tension into increase in area. That one you should find out and you will get it as 4s by r. You try to do that. That is a homework for you. Okay. So understood? Easy, right? Easy. All the things are easy. Very easy calculations. No integration, differentiation, nothing. So calculations are easy. That is the importance of this chapters. Okay. So I hope all of you understood all those things. And if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.